So, welcome everybody to our first ARTEC seminar of this year's Assembly Summer 2016. So first session will have a title of Your Privacy is Protected by What Exactly? So let's welcome our two speakers on the stage.
No. Yes.
Ooh.
Okay. Let's roll. So, we are here to tell you today about our certain complexities accumulated over the previous 20 or so years to our current technology that can make protecting your privacy a bit of a nightmare. Atte, start off with a video.
Yes. Now I will show you a video about that, what could happen if you open a browser and go to the website.
An unlikely scenario. So, basically, why we are here today is because we don't want that happen to you when you browse a web page, and that is the beginning of our research. So, enough about us. We are very serious researchers from Finland University. I'm Aimo, he's Atte, okay? But Atte, you could walk us through the previous video. What happened there?
Yeah, first you visit the web page, and then what happens, you are flooded by applications, and plenty of content opens in your desktop. Okay, all kinds of printers, cameras, and microphones get involved. And file recovering, you just hope you won't misclick anything.
So that anything you don't want to happen will happen. Okay, so what we saw in action were really something we call URL handlers. You must know a couple. Let's start with the most obvious one. HTTP, standing for the Hypertext Transfer Protocol. Basically, all the web pages are transported with HTTP or its cousin HTTPS. So this is a URL here. You've all seen this, right? So this is the server portion. It tells which server to get some content from. This part tells you which content is that. And this little creature here, that's the URL handler. It tells you what application, what protocol to use in order to view that content. You might know some others. For example, let's have a more modern one. You have probably used this creature for, getting your Linux ISOs or something. We thought that there must be a couple. We knew that there were a couple, and we started to research that one. So we thought that we would find something like a couple of dozen. We knew of a handful already before starting, but we actually find quite a lot. So from the really old ones, like this creature here, Gopher, that's the text-based internet of my youth, nothing that would appeal to you guys, to normal stuff like HTTP that we told of. In the background, it's a little hard to see all those weird Microsoft whatever things that we started to find when looking at this. But when you look at the whole picture, we, in a couple of weeks, by looking at like a dozen or a couple of dozen systems, found that there are like 400 different kinds of URLs. That means that a browser can open an application from a selection of these 400 or something. In reality, it's probably in the thousands. And that's one reason why we are here today, because this is all we could do, all we could think of within the space of a couple of weeks. But we want to catch them all. We want to catch all the browsers. We want to involve you in this work. So let's introduce that, shall we?
Yes. I'm Big Gamer. So in game clients, there are often in-game browsers like Steam web browser, EVE Online browser, Wii browser, Xbox browser, etc. And we want you to find out the interesting ones for us.
Yeah, we cannot figure it out ourselves, basically. And in your in your pocket, you have all these browsers, in the phones, in the phone applications, in the news applications, in the development tools. This is an example of Visual Studio. There is an inbuilt browser if you want to look at help pages to help with your programming. And there's all kinds of weird stuff. This is a prototype 3D internet from 2008. You don't really want to go there, but I suspect you know better of what's out there than we do. So here's the deal. We have three teams. We are yellow ourselves. Basically, pick a team, any team, and take this URL and basically share it with everyone, click it with everything that is clickable. And we are hoping that you will beat us. We are yellow, we are ourselves, and our support troops, which will be frantically clicking throughout this presentation. So Atte can explain a bit about spreading those.
Yeah, there are plenty of ways to spread URLs, like Steam chat, TeamSpeak, Skype, extra, and yes, we want you to share this with your friends and colleagues, and yeah,
and also sharing it with those and clicking in those, it's a pretty good way to find out if it has a browser. Let me recap. So three teams, catch all the browsers, pick a team, share the link, click on the link. That's it. But in the beginning, I must have told you that we are into security research. What does this, if anything, have to do with security? Can you explain, Atte?
Yes. URL handlers like Word, Microsoft Word, use remote content. And I will show you a video about that.
So you can open a web page. You can open Word documents from a web page. What's the security? What's the deal with security there?
Yeah, I will show you.
So what was that?
I will explain. Okay. first you open a browser, then you visit a website, and your remote document loads. What's then? Then you enable macros by accident or on purpose, and then all of your important files get encrypted. And then you have to go and buy some bitcoins if you want to recover.
So we don't actually recommend you to buy those bitcoins. Just wait a while, and some security researcher will think of a way to decrypt those files for you if they haven't already. But that's not the only one. That's not the only security issue, right? There must be some more.
Okay. There are many ad blocks nowadays. And they are trying to prevent all kinds of pop-up ads popping and ad content on pages and that. But what happens if you create AD content with URL handlers?
Yeah, he sent me a link. I'm still mad at you at that for that.
Yeah. I made a website that uses URL AD content, and I sent a link to Aimo, and let's watch how he reacted.
Our sound is missing.
Okay. Ah, well, that's annoying. I didn't know Wikipedia had pop-up ads. No.
So I wasn't really happy with that link, but it's payback time. It's payback time, I promise that. So it's not only Word. It's not only Twitter. Remember, we were talking about 400 different handlers. I think it must be in the hundreds of the freak show of all these applications that are out there. So, some examples. So, this was my revenge.
Yes, you sent to me this Candy Crush Soda Saga URL handler.
I knew that he had just bought a new computer with a default installation of Windows 10.
Yes, and when I bought it, I didn't know it has Candy Crush in it. And what happened when I put that Candy Crush Soda Saga URL handler in my Windows Edge browser? Candy Crush popped up to my desktop, and I was really shocked.
Yeah, but that's not all, though, is it?
Yes.
So, for example, in a Bitcoin application, there is a URL handler that you can not only... we previously thought that, okay, you can launch application, you can give them documents to process, but you also can give them commands. So, for example, this Bitcoin client accept this, that, okay, let's donate Jorma 666 bitcoins. Let's see how that pans out. So you get a pre-filled form saying that, okay, your send is already selected. If you press enter, okay, there go your bitcoins. Fortunately, I didn't have this many. But there are also pitfalls for gamers, right?
Yes. Okay. Steam has an URL handler, and you can set presets to URL handlers like uninstall. And what that does, it uninstalls your local game content. But what is that number, 730? It's a CSGO's Valve ID, and what that URL handler does is that it pop-ups this delete local game content prompt window, and I accidentally pressed delete button, and my CSGO was gone after that. Aimo, tell us more about maps.
Yeah, well, in most of the new systems and phones, you have these a variety of apps trying to transport you into some locations. Let's see what happens if you just have a maps URL for Groom Lake, Nevada, in somewhere. Let's say car navigator or browser or something. Yeah, well, that prompts your phone or your computer to try to transport you to Area 51. That's a silly example, but that's just to show you that you cannot really tell what is out there. There's bound to be plenty. So let's see how our challenge is doing. Can you show us, Atte?
Yes. Oh, it looks like yellow team is winning.
We are still winning. We are really disappointed in you. We told you that we don't want to win. So go.urlhandlers.info/blue or yellow with everything you got, please. So is this something to panic about? Well, yes and no. We've only shown you, as in any Qt security presentations, we've only shown you the worst examples. There are many software that, if a page has a URL handler, sensibly try to think that, okay, maybe I should ask the user on if he really wants to do something. For example, Chrome mostly seems to do it. Firefox sometimes seems to do it, and so forth. So it's not all this bad. But Atte, you can tell us all about a bit more severe.
Yes. One of the worst things that could happen to your computer is kernel panic. Real question is that, can you cause kernel panic with URL handlers? Let's find out. And okay.
So not one, but two panics.
Yes.
With a URL handler.
Yeah. But that works only with Firefox and older version of macOS X.
Yep. So that was basically it. Most of what we had to say. If we have one more key message, is that when some random dudes from the internet under assumed names come and tell you to click on everything, you might want to reconsider if that is a good idea. So we'll be available at least for today. Come and grab us. Most of the source code is on GitHub, so well, we would love if you participated in this research.
Yes.
So my real name is Juhani Jussi Eronen. I'm from the Finnish National Cyber Security Center, although I'm heavily involved in the research of the University of Oulu in some occasions.
Yes, and I am really Kasper Kyllönen, and I'm from OSPC, Oulu University Secure Programming Group, and I'm summer trainee.
So apologies for appearing under Aimo and Atte. It was necessary to convey the message. And these guys helped us to make the presentation, the videos, the back end, and whatever. So, next, last slide. And
yes.
This is live until the end of assembly. You still have time to beat us. Okay, that's it. Any questions?
What was the biggest surprise when you started to study these handlers?
You take it.
I think kernel panic was biggest surprise because it was really shocking that URL handlers can do that.
Yeah, for me, for me it was that out of the box, a Windows installation might have something like 120 URL handlers, a Mac even more. So I have no clue about exotic things like phones and car alarms and whatever.
What tools or, say, browser extensions or so on would you recommend to make this better and safer for people? And is there any browser right now that's safe enough that someone truly paranoid can actually browse the web?
You know better.
Actually, Google Chrome and Firefox are the best ones. They prompt before they do that URL launch.
I don't know of any extensions that deal with this. Do you?
No, Adblock doesn't deal with this at all.
So we would probably need new tools on that front.
Yeah.
You could probably, at least in Windows, just take away the registry entries. However, Varanti void or something, I don't know. I don't know what side effects they are.
Any other questions? So, no questions apparently. So be sure to go in to those handlers and click away and make yellow team lose at this point. Thank you.